Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. So in today's video, I'm going to be doing my shop my stash for the week. We're going to go through products I chose a few weeks ago and pick new products to use for the week. How was your week? We've been good over here. I've been so busy, you guys. It's been crazy. Like, honestly, I have so much going on in my personal life that YouTube has kind of been not a priority. I really enjoy creating content, but it's been hard to balance everything out. Just how busy with work, home, my daughter, sports, this, that. Yes, too much stuff going on. My husband working out of town, works, comes home, you know, there's just so much going on. So yeah, if you love Shop My Stash videos, definitely continue watching. If you're not yet subscribed, please subscribe and let's just go ahead and jump right in. So the first product I had from last week, I'm going to talk about it now, is my ABH Norvina palette volume 5. And this is beautiful, very pigmented. I love the purple looks I created. I definitely use like all of these colors. I used that shimmer, that one, that one, that one. I didn't reach for like those, but I had too many shadows to use the past couple weeks. The first week I had way too many shadows that I felt like I couldn't really use everything. So it kind of worked out that I had these products for 2 weeks, but I'm glad I did have it for 2 weeks so I can get more use out of them. And then the other palette I had was the Adept Heather Austin collab. This is beautiful. I've used every shade in here, but not this one or that one. I used this one today and it's so pretty. Like, it looks like coppery, but on the eyes it like shifts to green, like a lime green color. It's super pretty. So I definitely am loving this palette. The shimmers are absolutely amazing. The mattes are pretty nice. They're not overly pigmented or anything like that, but they are pretty nice. So I did definitely enjoy both of the palettes I had this week. I had a ton of makeup to use again the past couple weeks, so it kind of worked out. The first product down here, I have my Skin Glazing. It's pretty much a highlight in the shade Privilege. This one's really nice. It's like gold but pink. It's really, really beautiful. And then I had this bronzer by Nabla as well. I have the shade Dune. Again, very beautiful. It's not overly pigmented. It just looks really nice on the skin and it's not muddy or anything like that. One that was kind of muddy was actually this Jaclyn Duo in Stay Rosy and Yummy Toffee. The bronzer in here was actually pretty muddy on my skin. I don't know what's going on. The blush, I feel like it's a little too light. It does show up, but I have to pack it on. I don't know. I wasn't like impressed with this the past couple weeks that I used it. These, on the other hand, were super nice. These are the Bare Minerals Bronzers. This was in the shade of Pink. And then this is in the shade Kiss of Rose. It's really beautiful. They're more on like the, not shimmery, kind of glowy side. More glowy than shimmery. They're so beautiful. This one's more pigmented than this one, but it's also darker than this one. I really, again, enjoyed both. This, I really enjoyed the Danessa Myrick's Dewy Cheek and Lip Palette. It's really pigmented. A little bit goes a long way. You can see where I've kind of applied my beauty blenders, like the perfect marks right there. I really enjoyed this palette. The colors are beautiful. I definitely enjoyed these two more than these, but I enjoyed using this. I have another highlighter by Nabla. This is in the shade Amnesia. It's more of a gold shade. Very beautiful. It doesn't like sit on the skin. It just blends onto the skin very, very nice. Also had the Persona highlight in Zuma. This is also a gold highlight. Very beautiful. Also melts on the skin. I had my Urban Decay shadow in Cosmic. I rarely reach for my little shadows here, but this I did use a couple times. Concealer this week, I had these two. I had the Lancome Tintito Ultra Wear. I have the shade Buff in the shade 215. This is kind of like my skin color, so it doesn't brighten the under eyes. I feel like it doesn't, like my dark circles kind of peek through, so I came in my collection and picked up the Tarte Shape Tape in shade Light Sand. This is like a little too light, so mixing them both together, it kind of like brightened the under eyes, but not like overly brightening if I just use this on its own. Like, I mixed them both together. Has pretty good coverage, just that it's not a brightening color for me, so I feel like I could still see darkness, but mixing them together, it worked out pretty well. Primer, I use the Cover FX Dewy Skin. This is really good. You have to go like really, I was gonna say light-handed, but it's not light-handed. Like, you can't use a lot of product because it's overly like silicone-y a little bit, and a little bit goes a long way. So it does make my skin look really nice and healthy. I did enjoy it. It does kind of have a funky smell, but I noticed the smell when I bought it. I should have returned it just in case, but I kind of have been getting used to it. It's not like overly crazy smell or anything like that. So I don't know if it's about to expire or if that's just a scent. doesn't have a really good scent, but it works fine. Corrector, I use my Jeffree Star Cosmetics in the shade Peach. Corrects. This one's pretty good. The Flower Beauty Light Illusion Perfecting Powder. I have the shade Porcelain. Yep, L1. This is so pretty. I've used it on the under eyes. I've used it for the whole skin and to like smooth out my skin. It looks really, really pretty. I definitely enjoyed that. And then, of course, another powder that I like is a Huda Beauty in Pound Cake. Really pretty. Again, smooths the skin. It looks really good as well. Okay, I had a lot of products and a lot of lippies that are still staying in here. Mascaras, these two. First, I picked this Thrive Cosmetics one. I don't really like it. Yeah, it's a tubing mascara, but it doesn't volumize the lashes or anything. I feel like it's more lengthening than anything, and it probably is liquid lash extensions mascara. And then this one, I don't know. I remember I used to like it, and I just felt like it did nothing for my lashes, too. It just kind of coated them. Like, I wasn't amazed with either of these mascaras, so, yeah. I'm like, I need to purchase my Essence one, because that's just my favorite. Let's see what else, if I can take out. Okay, for brows, I had the Joa Beauty Precision Brow Pencil in Black Brown. This is kind of, like, more pigmented than I was used to. I guess I was using the Brow Wiz by ABH, and that one's not as pigmented as this. And I have to go light-handed with this because I can get a little crazy. And then I also use the Thick It, Stick It by NYX, or NYX, in the shade Espresso. I feel like the color isn't too crazy. I could have gone a little darker. It's more on the warmer side, but it works. And then liners, I had these two, LA Color and Urban Decay. This one's in Torch, and this one is a lip liner, but I use it on the waterline in the shade Cafe. And then this one, the Kaja, it's a wink stamp, so it was like a duo. It came with like a wing stamp, and then this, like a felt tip. This is not as smooth, or like it doesn't glide on the lid, so I'm actually going to put this in an empties. We can get rid of that. This usually stays over here. Oh, my eyeshadow primer that I used a couple weeks was a Kaleidos Tone Activator. Works really well. I could also take this out. The MAC lipstick, I used it as cream blush because I wouldn't really wear this kind of color on the lips. It's really pink. I don't know if it's pulling on camera or not, but this is in the shade High Fructise. It was really pretty as blush, and I didn't use these two. Yeah, those are Project Karen items. Oh wait, a couple more things. This is the Urban Decay Hydromaniac Tinted Glow Hydrator. I have the shade 30 Light. It's actually really nice. I feel like it's medium coverage. The color's a little light for me, but I feel like the shade up, I think, is light medium. And it looked a little orange. So this shade works out for me. So I really enjoy it. It's really nice and lightweight on the skin. I definitely enjoy it again. This one, I think I'm just going to declutter. I think I have, like, somewhere in here, the Professional Super Setter. I feel like my skin does look, like, smooth with this because it's supposed to be smoothing, I believe. But it spits at me sometimes, and it does remove some of my makeup. And you could see where I applied it. And one time, like, I applied it all over the skin. And usually I have to go in with my sponge and kind of, like, pat it on the skin so kind of blend out the spots. But I also noticed that some of my blush was missing because, again, it took out some of my makeup. So I am going to just call it quits. There isn't that much product. Again, I think it's, like, down here. So it might be the spritzer because there's not that much left, but I felt like I noticed that beforehand when it was full too. So again, I don't really like this, so I wouldn't purchase a full size. I have a mini of this, but I think I'm just end up putting it to a giveaway or something because I don't think I'm going to want to use it. And yeah, those are all the products in this week's Shop My Stash, or a couple weeks ago. So I also used the LYS Triple Skin Serum Foundation. I used the shade LN6. I feel like it's a little pink on me, but it still worked. Actually really like this. You can see I definitely used it up. I left it in here so I could tell you guys about it. Maybe I should try MN5. I feel like it's gonna be too dark for me. Maybe it'll work in the summer. It might be too dark though. I probably should have mixed both, but LN6, like, on its own was a little more better match than MN5 is. But I really like it. It's like medium coverage. I'm sure I could build it up possibly, but it looks super natural on the skin. It's a serum foundation, so maybe it's not supposed to be or won't be full coverage, but it looks really nice, like your skin, but better. It was really nice. I definitely want to pick up a full size of this for sure. So I really enjoy this, guys. So yeah, Again, those are all the products for this week's Shop My Stash. So let's go ahead and shop my stash.
Some products I want to use from the new makeup drawer. My makeup drawer is looking a little crazy. I don't know. I'm overbuying for sure, and I'm kind of embarrassed to show you guys my drawer. So I just picked a few things and brought them over here to share with you guys. I do have first impressions on the Jaclyn Hill stuff, so I definitely want to keep using these. Let me know if you guys picked anything up. What do you guys think of it? But definitely want to try these products out. This is a Jaclyn times Robin All Set Setting Spray. First impressions, it was, my skin did look a little dewy, but again, I want to get more use out of it. So this will be my setting spray for the week. And then the powder is the, I got in the shade Sheer Fair. This is a loose setting powder. I actually really liked it. And I thought it was pretty smoothing as well. So we're going to take that. We're also going to take the eyeliner I picked. This is in the shade Smooth Blackberry. It was really beautiful, like a dark brown red color. So again, we're taking that. And then her eyeshadow palette. What is this called? The Luxe Legacy Eyeshadow Palette. And it looks like this. I've only used it the time I filmed with it, so I definitely want to get more use out of it. I already know what palette I want to use from my collection because I was going to pick up a palette from Unearthly Cosmetics, previously known as Alien Cosmetics. And I was like, girl, you don't need that palette. You have a color story that looks like that. So yeah, I am going to use this, and I'm going to use the other palette that I've been thinking about getting, or color story wise. Also picked up this Dior Backstage Rosy Glow blush. I got the shade pink. My friend texted me and she's like, girl, I just picked this up from Sephora. It's back in stock, and I used my little fingers to try to get on the Sephora app and ordered it, and this hasn't even sold out. I don't know if it's sold out now, but like the next day it was still available, or like a few hours later too. So I was like, girl, we like hurried up to get it and it's still available. And she's like, what? You know, because usually this sells out. So this is in the shade pink. I want the peach one too. So we're going to use this. Supposedly this is kind of like a, supposed to like blend onto your cheek. I think like, what's it called? Like a, it says it's a Color Awakening Universal Blush. So it's not going to look like how it looks like in the pan. As you can see, like it supposedly changes with your, I think with your skin tone. I don't know, but we're gonna take this. And then I also picked this up, the Winky Luxe, what is this called, full coverage under eye concealer. This is in the shade light. I've heard like this was a raved product on TikTok. I guess it like blew up. It's not a new product, but I got my hands on it, so we're gonna try that. And a lot of people have been talking about the Maybelline Age Rewind, so I picked up the concealer shade, which I don't know if it's gonna work for me. It kind of looks like my skin tone. And then a corrector shade as well. So people have been raving about these again, so I decided, let me pick those up and try them out again and see what we think. And then I also want to use these two primer samples. I kind of wanted to pick up a full size of this, but then I was like, what if I don't like it? This is the Laura Mercier Pure Canvas Primer. It's the blurring one. So this is what it looks like the actual packaging. So I want to use both of these and see what I think of them. I usually save my Ulta points so I can buy like high-end stuff or get high-end stuff for free. And this was one of the products that I wanted to get. So I'll try these two out, see what I think of them. And if I really enjoy it, then I know I want to pick up the full size. So I'm going to take that. And then I think that's it for the new makeup. So we have a setting spray, a foundation. I actually have that one from My Face and Body by MAC as well. But actually, I want to use the Catrice one. I know I've used this at least a month or two ago, and I still don't remember what I think of this. Like, I forget. Like, I know I like this one, this one, this one, this one, this one. Which one's this one? Oh, I love that one. I know what I think of this, but I keep forgetting what I think about this one. So this is a Catrice True Skin Hydrating Foundation. I have the shade 20 Warm Beige. This is my foundation for the week. Let me go ahead and pick the palette. I'm just gonna move it over here and move it down. I have a box over here, don't mind that. And the palette I want to use is not in this one, it's in this one. I want to use the Lime Crime Venus XL. So the palette I wanted from Unearthly was like this kind of color story. So I was like, girl, you have this and you can just use this, you know, because it comes with like a burgundy and all these colors. So this will be perfect to pair with the Jaclyn palette, even though I have a lot of shades in the Jaclyn palette. These tones are different, you know what I mean? They're more pinky tones. So we'll get more use out of this and then use the Jaclyn palette as well. Back over here. Okay, first drawer, mascara. I've just not been feeling a lot of these mascaras. Let me take these two because I think I enjoyed these two. This is a Bite Beauty Upswing Full Volume Mascara. And then the ABH. I also had tried like another trial size and I did enjoy it. So we're going to take both of these for mascara. And then eyebrows. I'm going to take the Precisely My Brow and also the Gimme Brow. And then eyeshadow primer. I want to focus on my one in my project pan because usually I have another primer, so I'm just going to work on this one, the Ulta Beauty Matte Eye Primer. It's getting there. Okay, concealer. So I have a corrector. I should pick something that's lighter because I think my Maybelline one's going to be too dark for me. You know, one what's light is this Benefit one, so we're going to take the Benefit one. This is in the shade number 3, so if I need a little brightening pick me up, then I will use this with the Maybelline primer. I have the Laura Mercier primer. Let me also pick this MAC Prep and Prime Skin Base. I just have the regular one. And we'll focus on these because I really want to use these up. These will probably be a couple uses each, so there's only 7 days in the week. That's all I'm gonna pick. Powder. We have the Jeclyn powder, so we don't need a powder. Okay, we'll be testing that out. Bronzer. I'm gonna take the Samantha collab in River. We're gonna take that. I'm excited to get new products because I was using it for a couple weeks. So I was definitely ready to change. So I have a pinkish blush. Let me take this so I could test it out. This is one of the older blushes in my collection. So I want to see if it still has pigment. This is in the shade Toasted Cinnamon. I had the peach one and it definitely was... Oh my gosh. There's like a wind. And I don't know if you guys can see, but look. Look outside. crazy. It's a little crazy out there. And dirt. The other one I had wasn't pigmented anymore, so I want to test that out. And then let's also test out... Let's do this Note one. This is in the shade Desert Rose. This one's really pretty. It's pretty pigmented too, so definitely more pigmented than the other two. I didn't even go heavy-handed with this one, and you could see pigment compared to those two. So those will be my blush for the week. Highlights. I don't have any highlight picked out. I'm gonna take this little mini one by Bare Minerals in the shade Free. Super cute and small. Right there. And then this Mally Beauty. Let's take this one too. This is in the shade Stardust. It's like a gold also. This one's definitely more gold than that one. That one's more champagne. If you guys couldn't tell on camera. I think that will be good. Maybe let's take this Laura Mercier one too in the shade 01. More paler than the others, so that should be good. Eyeliner. I need to roll in a liner in my project pen. Yeah, I need to roll in one. I'm feeling this blue, so we're gonna take this one by ColourPop in the shade Style and Ease. Cute denim color here. And then let's take the spaghetti straps from Fenty Beauty as well. Right there. Cute. Okay. Those will be our eyeliners for the week. And I usually have like a purple, a green, and a blue that is just sits in my shop mustache. Let's see. I'm gonna take the Too Faced Better Than Love. I need to bring in some eyeliners over here. I have some in the backup drawer, but I don't use this stuff in the backup drawer. But if they were sitting in here, I could actually use them instead of them drying up in the backup drawer, if that makes any sense. So yeah.
also have these that I need to take out, and I think that's it. So those are all the products for this week's Shop My Stash. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up. Please subscribe if you haven't already. And I will see you all in my next video. Bye.